Choosing a college you'd like to attend is important. You may spend anywhere from a few months at that college to possibly 4, 5, 6 years by the time you graduate. So you just will be going to an institution that's friendly, where you feel comfortable, where you really feel like who you are is being affirmed by the institution itself. College and university education is expensive. Now, as a student, you pay some tuition even at a public college or university, but you pay a small portion of the total cost of you being there as a student. Between what the government pays, what you pay yourself in tuition, and the amount of money you would have earned if you were working full-time, say, in a minimum wage job instead of going to university or going to college, the investment you make in a college education is fairly substantial. You should be looking at spending the kind of time that you would spend if you were researching purchasing a new car or possibly purchasing a new home into determining which college or which university you would like to attend. So research is very important. You want to start with the academic research. First of all, does the college or university offer the program you want? Then you'll want to check through all of the courses that are required for the program. Read the description. Get a sense of what you're going to be doing in each class. Read the descriptions of all of the optional or elective courses in that particular degree program or in the diploma program. Make sure you really get what the program is all about. Check the reputation of the institution. I recommend contacting employers that work in that particular field. Check with them to get a sense of what are the graduates like. What is the reputation of that particular college or university in industry? What kind of sense do people out in the world have about the institution you're planning on attending? If it's a private college or a university, I consider it to be a must to Google the name of the institution along with the word fraud. Get a sense of if there are people who are really unhappy. Now, you want to take this with a bit of a grain of salt. Every institution, regardless of how good or how bad, is going to have a few students who are unhappy and disgruntled. And in some cases, their complaints are really not very legitimate. But if you see page after page after page on Google searches that show the word fraud with the institution you're thinking of attending, it should be a bit of a red flag. You want to do more investigation before you make a final decision. I recommend considering the customer relations. What does the institution seem like when you phone, when you email, when you write? What kind of responses are you getting? How quickly do you get the answers? Do the answers seem to be fairly good? Do the people seem like they genuinely want to talk to you, they enjoy their jobs, and they'd like to have more students around? The reason why I say this, colleges and universities have a tendency to treat potential students slightly better than students who are there. Because a student who's already there has made a big investment, they're likely to stay in the college or university. But a brand new potential student, that's somebody they want to impress. So kind of watch for the customer relations. I recommend checking to see what kind of benefits the institution provides for people in same-sex partnerships. That doesn't necessarily mean you're going to get the full sense of what the college or university's feeling is for a gay, lesbian, bisexual, or trans student, but it does help a little bit. Do they offer same-sex partners the same benefits that they offer straight, married people? That's an important one to check. You may want to also Google to see if you can get a sense from internet web pages if any of the college or university teachers are doing research specifically related to gay, lesbian, bisexual, or trans issues. That's an important one to gauge the sense of comfort of the institution with sexual minority people. You will be checking for more than just the atmosphere of the college, but definitely do a Google search with the university or college's name and atmosphere or atmosphere study to see if they've done any studies of the campus climate. You might even use the words campus climate, to see if there are any potential problems there and to see how the administration is responding to problems with the environment if it doesn't feel safe or doesn't feel affirming for some particular groups on campus. The atmosphere of the town, the small city, or the big city where the college or university is located is very, very important. And community resources make a difference in terms of the atmosphere of the college or the university. No college or university operates in complete isolation. The community atmosphere does make a difference. You want to check the atmosphere of the communities, both the learning community, which is your college or university, as well as the community of the town or city where that particular institution is located. Look to see what resources are there, because community resources make a big difference on the atmosphere of the community and how comfortable you're going to feel there. For example, does the college or university have a GSA, a Gay Straight Alliance? Does the college or university have a gay lesbian center? Does the town or city have a gay lesbian center? Google the town or the city to see how many openly gay business owners there are, to see what businesses are owned by the queer community, and that will give you a sense of how comfortable people in the queer community feel about being open and out in that particular city. You may not choose to ever frequent any of the gay-owned establishments, but it's nice to know that they're there to have a sense of belonging and a sense of how big the community is for you. I always recommend visiting the campus of the college or university. Walk across the campus, get a sense of how it looks and how it feels to you. Do you feel comfortable with the size of the institution? Are you intimidated by it, or are you excited and energized by it? As you walk through the campus, does the campus feel attractive enough to you that it's a place that you might look forward to going to every day? Because it's going to be important, because you're going to be spending a chunk of time on campus, taking classes, reading, studying, researching things in the library. You want the place to feel good, to look good, and to make you feel good. You also want to kind of keep a sixth sense out. Do you feel safe as you go through the campus? Do you pick up emotions that make you feel uncomfortable, or do you pick up emotions that make you feel comfortable? You are welcome to check the academic advising and the counseling resources pages on our website, www.adlc.ca. Check out our online resources for gay, lesbian, bisexual, trans, and questioning youth, www.adlc.ca, or give us a call, toll-free, no charge, 1-866-774-5333.